What's up, people? It's the Catman here in Leicester at Athena, and it's going to be the biggest and baddest comedy show this side of the planet. And your host, the Catman, will be here, as well as, I do believe, Mr. C and Marlon Davis, Mr. Frazier. What's that? Don't tell them any more about the show. If they want to see it, they can watch the outtakes of this clip. Oh, see that? I don't even have to tell you. Look, you're going to see some amazing acts. And I want to know, where were you guys? Because I'm celebrating my birthday weekend right here up in Leicester. And I can't understand why you were missing. If you're watching it and you saw the show, then you know how good it was. And or good it is. Or how good it's about to be. Depending on where they put this in the DVD. So, get your inhalers out if you've got asthma, and get your E45 cream out if you've got eczema, and get your man out, because I'm about to tell you a new backside, and I don't want you going, oh my gosh, isn't Cat really funny and so buff, and upset him, because men have egos and it kind of crushes them, and I just need you to understand that. So keep watching this space, because it's the Catman in another place. Can I have some more brandy now, because my medication for my sexual Tourette's is kicking in.
Yeah, bigger the better, man. I tell you, skinny girls, you can't do nothing with a skinny gal. You can't make love to a skinny gal. Every time you do, it's called assault. Yes, with a big girl, you're and she's like almost sexually firing you back, because she goes, what is that it? Skinny girl, you go, she goes, oh, stop it. I'm bruised now. I got bellyache. I think you moved my heart over. I can't even remember now what your name is. You just pushed everything. Can't do it, skinny girl. You're just like, you know, it's like putting on a condom. You know, you go, and they just go. You remember Aliens, the first one? It's like that. You go, she goes, get it out.
So this is the last laugh in Leicester. And it's an Asian and Black comedy night, but because it's Diwali, none of the Asians have turned up and it's all Black. And I'm going on to loads of Black people, but that's all right, you know. I've lived in Brixton and stuff, and I know how it is. And so there's going to be two or three Asians in there, but they're those Asians. You know those Asians you find in Leicester who think they're Black? It's those, innit? Like, and all that business, innit? So I think it's going to go all right. Well, I think so. I might get stabbed at the end, but you never know.
Hello. I'd like a tattoo. What of? Of a dragon. Yes. Where would you like that? I'd like it to look like it's just crawled out of my ass. I was looking at these girls thinking, what have you done to yourselves? One of these girls turns around to me, she starts going. Now you know you're going to get stabbed, yeah? I said, have you forgotten to brush your teeth, love? She went, no, this is how we're talking it, Ross. Then a friend joined in and started. I thought, what are these noises they keep making? It's not even a language. Have we not evolved beyond monkeys? Do you think that when these girls take their kids to the zoo, there's chimps in the cages going, do you know what? Their diction is awful.
Film this because VJ, sorry, I got food in my mouth. I apologize. Yeah, I've got food in my mouth. I'm going to go and pick up Mr. C now. It was a great show. And it's called Last Laugh. BJ, there's a promoter there. This is the guy who's getting all your money. Look at that. Look how he's glowing. Look at his skin. Beautiful. This guy takes 5 holidays a year. Turn it back to me. Fuck him. So anyway, did I swear? Is he going to the internet? Are you allowed to swear? Sorry, all right. They don't need to edit that. This guy here puts on great shows all the time. How many shows do you put on a year? 3? 6, 7. And you only get me for 1. Fuck this. Forget about Last Laugh. Don't go. If I'm not there, Kane Brown. That's what I'm saying. No, seriously. Shazia, Mirza, Marlon Davis was on tonight. Mr. C, Mr. Frazier, the Catman from MTV, me, Kane Brown. Was there anything else? Mm-hmm. No, that's it. Addict. Oh, Addict. Oh, they were good. You don't missed it. There was a bit. Oh, you should see it. Make sure the cameraman shows it. Basically, this guy was dirty whining.
Serious.
You need to see it. This white guy. Funny as hell.
Shuffling.
What's your name, sir?
David.
David.
David. Was it natural for you to be able to dance on the beat like that, or was it lots of training? Because I've never seen so many people that are white that can dance to music in time. No, because I've been to raves, and you know when sometimes when you start dancing, it fucks me up. It does. Because you dance, and then I miss the beat. So then I'm looking for, you know, any brother or sister in the room that can put me back in the... Yeah, that's about wicked, wicked. And you had these, I see these are working it, just pop, pop. I was like, rah, these are working it. They're not to be ramped with. Was it difficult? Was it, you know?
A bit both.
Have you ever tried dancing to bashment?
Yeah.
You have? Where yous are going? Come back. You're part of ADDICT, Selecta, because this is my new dance troupe. When I go on tour and stuff, these are going to come with me and open up the thing. Watch how my dance group carry on. They're going to mash up the blood clot blaze. You ready? Selecta!
Wagwan, pop gun.
They are not at school, but tell me something. And when you get the new flags, they daddy. I wish color that, I did not party. You alone have the style, they daddy. The king, the England, I feel love a bloody. When you get the new flags, they daddy. I wish color that, I did not party. You alone have the style, they daddy. The king, the
England, I feel love a bloody. Let's go!
Real bad man, no. Your jeans, no. Everybody have the arms when we get the clocks. The leather hat, the sweat sock. Toothbrush get up, it does fast.
Pull up! That's what I'm talking about up inside the place. Do not ramp with them. They go by the name of ADDICT. What's their name? Representing Leicester, that's why they were number one in the country at Bumber Cleat. Make some noise for your crew.
Okay, good evening, everybody. How you doing? Hope you're doing good. My name is Leo Muhammad, and there's a rumor going around that I know this character by the name of Frazier. You may be familiar with him. Lots of people know him from The Real McCoy. He's supposed to be this big superstar, the man ugly like sin. And everywhere I go, he follows me around. I look around, the man is there. I look around, he's there all the time. But apparently he's going to be on the stage tonight. He's going to be entertaining the people, making them laugh. And, you know, he's got this company called Brock Teat Productions. And so, you know, for those of you who are not familiar, you should go and check him out on YouTube, man. The man is just, he's just awesome. He's just on another level.
Right about now, you're live and direct with Mr. C, comedian, backstage here at Last Laugh. Now, me don't know about Last Laugh, but I know, say, I'm on first, so me, I got to give you the first laugh. So, right about now, you've got a lineup tonight of some of the wickedest comedians that I've ever worked with. So, I know I'm coming out first, and then my good homeboy Marlon's coming out after me, followed by Mr. Frazzle himself. We've got the man like the Catman hosting. So, the way I look at it, that's the first half, and I'm coming out first. I'm coming to kill the audience. I'm coming to bring jokes right into their throat. Right, you know when you get a... that's what I'm looking to do tonight. But I don't know what to expect, because out there look a bit stush, and as you look, I kind of a bit underdressed and stuff. And because what it is really, I was doing an advert for famine relief today, as you can see by the neck here. Have you got a dumpling that you could spare for me? Two dumplings. If you send 20 pence a month to Mr. C 08443, you can help feed this comedian. Because the jokes ain't working for me right now.
I know Cat was giving it up really kind of really bad on the skinny girls. Skinny girls, I'm here to defend you. I'm a skinny man as well. But the only thing is the two of us can't fuck. That's the only thing. No, because I've tried it. I've tried skinny women many a times. And skinny man... skinny woman, it don't work. You got issues, I got issues. And plus, I've tried it. You know, like when you first meet them and then you get a little bit romantic and you start rub the back and start rub the front and you get in a bed and her leg rub against mine, my leg rub against hers. Next thing I know, the duvet pan fire. I'm telling her, drop, roll. She can't hear me, so me have to start pee-pee pan her. She looking at me saying, you're like R. Kelly, you are. You're like R. Kelly. That's not romantic, is it? That's health and safety. That's what that is. Health and safety, man. No, I do, man. I love our culture, man. I love our culture. I've got three sons, 6, 9, and 23. Yeah, I know, man. I know. And I've got to try and bring them up in a country where a black male is public enemy number one. And things have changed in the world now. Because I remember when I was growing up at school, like sports day, the most important thing to me at school, at sports day, was winning that race. But it ain't like that anymore. I take my children to sports day. My children, who usually come first, and now the little fathead child, who usually come last, they're giving both of them the same round chocolate medal. Because they're trying to tell my sons, it's not about winning. It's about taking part. So I said to my son them straight, no, because you know what? Sometimes as a man, you have to motivate your children. You have to talk to your children and encourage them to be the best that they can be. So I tell my son, sit down here. Pick up the drink and sit down. 3 days I have him sitting down. No Cartoon Network. I'm going to motivate you. Because I want you to win this race. Not for daddy. He looked at me and said, not for daddy. I said, no, not for me. He said, you want me to win it for me, daddy? I said, no, that'll be selfish, you little selfish brute. I don't want you to win it for you. I want you to win it for mommy. And you don't know what it's like when you have your son look at you with his eyes bright, and he said, you want me to win it for mommy? And I said to him, yes, son, I want you to win it for mommy, because if you don't win it for mommy, mommy will die. You want to see him on sports day, lining up. Mommy! Bang, he run, cry. And they saying, go on, son, he shouted, mommy!
You enjoy yourself tonight?
That was fantastic.
I had a great time, you know. I've left Marlon out there just sitting there. He's just going, wow, what a show as well. And, you know, I've had an amazing time. We didn't have to lick our wounds.
Oh, it was good. Everybody did well. He kept it together. Energy. Jumped into the crowd like some madman and standing up next to some girl who was 6'12". That's what he did. And you know he's not too tall already. How tall are you, Kat?
I'm 5'7".
Oh, there you go.
But it's because I had great people to work with, like Kane Brown and, you know, Marlon Davis, and not forgetting Mr. C. Mr. Frazier. And my homegirl, Shazia, she was representing. As well as Addictive, they were wicked. The dance group, you know, we'll cut between names to make it easier for the edit. But I've had a great time, people. And if you were here tonight, thank you so much. You know what happened, what went down. And if you weren't here, you can just watch it on Twitter, Facebook, and any other social media going, "Rah, is that what happened that night?" I've had a great time celebrating my birthday, Diwali, and me and Kane Brown's new collaboration together, which we can't tell you about for legal reasons until it's signed off. But you heard it here first. Till next time, Catman signing out. See, I'm a comic now, so I can do this.